Smoke a purse so sweet with Hot Thoughts TV.
Y'all know what the fuck we doing, man. It's Hot Thoughts TV. Niggas hot in the bitch, man.
I'm smoking a purse so sweet with Hot Thoughts TV.
But back on the questions that you had asked me, I started doing events in middle school, high school, JU promotions, you know what I'm saying? A lot of motherfuckers that came through that cycle and came to the parties or was part of Just Us promotions with Big Terrell, you know what I'm saying, the JU van, you know what I'm saying, all that type of shit. So, you know, even during that time, I didn't know what I was doing. I just know I was having fun. You feel me? And that's why I do shit with passion now. Because I used to go around with him every Sunday and give flyers to three or four different kids from certain high schools to pass out during the week. So I knew the top three fine bitches from Hastings and Taylor. And you know what I'm saying? I knew who the niggas was having motion at Elsick. And you know what I'm saying? So I really knew motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying? Like just off that shit, you know what I'm saying? Nobody else knew that this was going on. So now, you know, after high school, doing sports and shit like that, I really didn't know what I was gonna do. Once I didn't get any offers in sports from, you know, playing at Willow Ridge and shit like that, nigga, grades were not all that decent type shit, you know what I'm saying? I was like, shit, I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do. And one day I just went downtown on some random shit, and I was walking by this club, and I seen my partner D. Brooks. You feel me? This was my best friend, cousin. And he a nigga that used to see me at the high school parties, but he never said nothing to me. And he just remembered me because he knew I went to high school with Donovan, which was his cousin. He played tight end, I played quarterback. You know what I'm saying? So he seen me, he was like, hey, what's going on, bro? Boom, boom, you know what I'm saying? My big bros, they got me promoting this shit, you know what I'm saying? It was the promotion team, and we promote this club right here called I Bar. You know what I'm saying? You need to jump down with this shit, bro. You been doing this shit. You feel me? And shit, he introduced me to his partners at the time. I think I had a fade with a ducktail type shit, and you know, they was from Third Ward type shit, you know what I'm saying? So they wouldn't, you know, they wouldn't really fit in that shit. They were like, bro, this nigga got a ducktail, like, you know what I'm saying? What the fuck, bro, I got going on, you feel me? But they not understanding that I'm one of the most popping niggas they've ever met, you know what I'm saying? But they found out slowly but surely, you know what I'm saying? Because my first event, my first college party that they put me on, I sold 100 pre-sales at $20 each. I sold actually 102 of them. So I had $2,040 in my pocket before the doors even opened. And I had 100 people with me. They had never seen that. But all I did was tell motherfuckers I knew from Madison, tell niggas I motherfuckers I knew from Willow Ridge, motherfuckers I met at TSU, everybody who stayed in Greystone with me, Courtyard, Till Wester, hey, I got a party and y'all need to pull up with me. And we carpooled to that hoe and shit, the rest is history. You know what I'm saying? From that one event, I went from my family's couch to a condo downtown. Cause my two partners at the time, once they seen me, they moved me into their house the next day. Mm-hmm. And I never looked back.
You being like connected in the city, like since the early age, like you said, you know, 14, 15, you already touching the scenes that a lot of people, you getting a head start. Like in your opinion, from the outside looking in, what's like the reason you think that you able to connect so many dots in the city, like on a genuine level, like you said, people see you years down the line and recognize your work, or you know what I'm saying, just your work ethic and shit like that. What do you think is the key to that?
I think it's vibes and energy, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm self-efficient, you feel me? I'm always have my own shit going on, you feel me? And shit, you know, like, I'm a Leo, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just on some positive shit. You feel me? Like, you only gonna know the negative side of me unless you take me there, or, you know what I'm saying, cause a situation for me to go there. But other than that, I'm good vibes, bro. I'm cool as a fan. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't gonna trip with you. But I think just being a stand-up nigga, I think people being able to take your word for shit. So if you say this tree is green, you know, that I really gonna be green. Like, people like having the security of knowing that I can trust bro and what he say, and he gonna keep it real with me. You feel me? A lot of people don't be doing it, and a lot of us has been through shit, you feel me? And been through fucked up situations with people that we loved or fucked with, it was cool with. So when you meet a stranger that's keeping the bean with you out the rip, and you notice it and you appreciate it, you gonna fuck with me. You know what I'm saying? Cause nine times out of 10, I'm gonna help you and do more for you than you can do for me, or that you gonna do for me, because I don't need you for anything. You know what I'm saying? So shit.
So, taking it a step further, you were throwing the shows, you were, like you said, self-sufficient, making shit shake already. When did you take it upon yourself to say, okay, let me go ahead and try to manage an artist or get into that field?
The thing about it is, my two partners, my big bros, Tay and J-Boy, they really just was really running the business. When niggas thought we was just promoting and throwing parties and passing out flyers on the TSU campus, we really was running the business. We really had expenses. We really was investing back into the business. You know what I'm saying? Like, we really was, you know what I'm saying, out here branding our shit and creating new party themes that niggas still using to this day. You know what I'm saying? Like, we really was pushing the culture, you feel me? And, you know, just creating a niche for, like, black excellence. You know what I'm saying? Even though we didn't all the way know it. But so I did the college parties for like 5-6 years. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was so good, bro. Like, you know, at one point niggas was making $20,000 twice a month. I'm 18, 19 years old. Like, I never had a job. Like, I'm thinking this shit never was gonna stop. You feel me? Like, even in the wintertime we was eating. You know what I'm saying? Thanksgiving, Christmas, like all the big plays, like we was, you know what I'm saying? We was killing. Like, nobody was fucking with us. Like, it was at one point in time where the detox events and parties was the main attraction in the Houston nightlife. You know what I'm saying? Once Ibar and the downtown had closed down, like, our shit was the bread and butter of the city. So, you know, because we had a crazy combination. You know what I'm saying? Because I was in college at the time, and on top of that, I was from the hood and lived in multiple hoods. You feel me? So with that, you take niggas from the streets and you put them in a club or a venue with some music with, you feel me, 20, 21-year-old girls from Oregon, Kentucky, and motherfucking Louisiana that never seen a nigga with gold teeth or never seen a bottle being popped before. You feel me? Because they never went to a club in Houston yet, because the TSU community is close-knitted. If you ain't from there or go to school there, they're not going to be going to your events because you have no access on campus or the dorms to be able to promote your shit. And that's why another reason why I used to kill, because niggas used to come and pay me, or if I fuck with you, they'll come say, hey, Deezy, have one of your promoters or have one of your chicks come open the gate for me so I can come and pass our flyers. We got a concert this weekend. Oh yeah, man, you bring some chicks and y'all can come get a section, boom, boom. Y'all just, you know, pass out flyers for me on campus. Or sell tickets for me, D, you know what I'm saying? Like, little shit like that. But that's only if I fuck with you, because I didn't work for niggas, because I was my own boss. Right. You feel me? But once I started doing that, it got to a point where as though I wasn't able to be on campus a lot, because I had kids and had just different little shit I had to, you know what I'm saying, be responsible for and allocate to. So it wasn't, I couldn't put the same time into it. So it started, you know, showing in the amount of money that nigga was making compared to the amount of time and effort that it takes to do one event. Because you gonna invest 6 weeks in advance or 4 weeks in advance, and then you gotta promote for 4 weeks, gas to go do this and go pull up at the Gallo in Charlestown to pass out flyers here, go meet this person, go sell these pre-sales here. You know what I'm saying? Before you know it, you know what I'm saying, you in the negative. You feel me? But I won't get a dollar back from this money I put up 4 weeks ago until the night of the party.